West Virginia is where I found my life's purpose, my spiritual calling. My life's journey led me to West Virginia, inexorably, inevitably. And it is in West Virginia that I hope my legacy will be remembered and my journey as a public servant understood.
So as he prepares to retire from the United States Senate and launch a new phase of his life, he says he still feels a commitment and a calling to serve others. I will not be leaving West Virginia, he said when he announced his retirement. West Virginia will always be my home. I know his wife, Sharon, who is with us today, shares exactly those same feelings. So I'm honored to announce that in three landmark ways, Senator John D. Rockefeller IV will have a forever home at West Virginia University. First, the university libraries will be the permanent home of the John D. Rockefeller IV Senatorial Archives. The Rockefeller Archives will be priceless resources, let me just say that again, priceless resources for learning and research. Students and researchers from around the world will visit the collection, explore its treasures, and extract novel insights that help us better understand our own history.
The John D. Rockefeller IV Senatorial Archives will be really a cornerstone of the West Virginia and Regional History Center's outstanding political collection.
I hope when people read these volumes, they will better understand both the legislative issues, but also me, and why I fought so hard and continue to and will ever continue for those least able to fight for themselves. I want my archives open to the people as a living record of my work. I want them to teach. I want them to be debated. I want them to inspire people into public service and policy for generations to come. I want that to happen very, very much.
Senator Rockefeller will also have a forever home here in the Downtown Wise Library's John D. Rockefeller IV Gallery, which we are dedicating today to honor his 5 decades of service to West Virginia. It will feature exhibits and displays of documents, photographs, and objects that reflect the senator's life and career. The most lasting monument to Senator Rockefeller's work, however, will be the future leaders he inspires to dedicate their own lives to fulfilling that common duty of mankind, service to others. That is why I'm especially pleased to announce the new John D. Rockefeller IV School of Policy and Politics at West Virginia University. The school brings together our academic programs in political science, public administration, international studies, and leadership studies, 4 areas in which Senator Rockefeller has clearly distinguished himself. So consistent with Senator Rockefeller's career in public service, this school will help our university fulfill its land-grant mission. It will capture the breadth and depth of our expertise and apply it to meet the needs of West Virginians.
As a student who views policy and politics as inextricably linked in my own research agenda, the creation of this school is a valuable and natural progression. To have the support of Senator Rockefeller in this endeavor is truly an honor.
My idea of service was never really about giving speeches like this or cutting ribbons or walking in parades. Instead, it was a career undertaking with the singular recognition that public service is a high and noble calling, one that understands that none of us exists solely for ourselves, but rather for the sake of others.
Along with Senator Rockefeller, we at West Virginia University share a commitment to serving West Virginia, a common goal. We are proud that the senator's papers, the senator's galleries, and the senator's school will have a forever home, in his words, on our campus, and that his legacy of service will be forever part of our identity and our mission.
My vision, and one that President Gee and WVU shares, is a place that ignites the embers of service and scholarship in scores of young men and women for years and years to come, setting them on a path to utterly transforming West Virginia, and maybe just a little bit the world.